government, of the people, by the people, and for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
Sure, my name is Cameron Webb, and I'm actually, I just finished my third year of medical school.
Your third year of medical school?
Yeah, well, I'm a fourth year now, but I'm taking a leave of absence and getting my law degree.
Oh, wow.
And the reason is I'm interested in health legislative advocacy, a lot of what's going on right now.
For a JD.
Correct. Right. And I'm doing that in Chicago, and so that's why I moved. And I saw this opportunity with Change the Works, and it really kind of fit with a lot of what I'm interested in. I think that, you know, what they're doing in the community to really get out and spread the word about the presence, help inform and I just thought that we need to find creative ways to get the word out. As a future practitioner, and I'm sure you can relate, I have a concern about the future of my practice and how, like, you know, 40 years from now, where will my patients be?
Well, you'll be also at the intersection with law and legislation, because one of my interests have also been in not just practice, but the bigger picture, so we need people like you to cover that.
That's what I'm doing, and as I'm sure you can understand, it's hard to take time away from med school, but for me, I was just like, I want to really train myself in both so I can be really
Where
effective.
Where are you at med school?
I did med school at Wake Forest.
Oh, Wake Forest, yeah.
And law school at Loyola University.
So do you have any healthcare stories or issues?
Well, my health insurance was $220 as a med student at 24 years old, and for me, that was frustrating. And I just canceled my insurance for a little while because I was just trying to pay all my bills, you know.
So you're actually not insured now?
Yeah, well, I am now, but I'm on my wife's insurance because she's doing a residency, so that's where I got my health insurance. But, you know, for a while, for about 2.5 years, I was uninsured. And you know, really, a lot of my experiences, a lot of my stories have to do with a lot of patients that I've worked with and their issues. And I can tell you a million of them. I mean, one guy came in, he had antiphospholipid syndrome, but he wouldn't stay overnight because he knew how much the workup would cost and how much a room night would cost in the hospital. He's 25 years old.
So you know patients that basically forego medical care.
Absolutely. And I mean, that's frustrating to see as a practitioner, because you want to do what you think is the best for your patients. So
yeah, it's interesting. As a doctor, you know, a lot of we learn in medical school, we have a lot of tools and everything to take care of patients, but we're limited, we can't cure everything, and that's very frustrating. Now, layer upon that, we can't take care of everybody because they don't have, you know, insurance, they don't have the money, or they don't have this, that. We already have certain limits in our knowledge.
Right.
To add these structural limits is very frustrating.
And I mean, I think we have a good opportunity to make some headway.
I think the time is now.
Yeah,
that's why I'm walking.
Right.
Talking to you.
Thanks,
Cameron. Can I have your signature?
Sure.
Now, just sign your full name.
That from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain. That this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom. And that government, of the people, by the people, and for the people, shall not perish from the earth.